My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Savior. So sang Mary as she waited to give birth, remembering the prophet Isaiah's words that a young woman would become pregnant and give birth to a son who would become Emmanuel, meaning God with us. Bonsoir et bienvenue à cette célébration, elle de Noël à la chandelle de l'église de Saint-Andrew and Saint-Paul. C'est mon grand plaisir de vous accueillir n'importe où que vous êtes ce soir. Good evening and welcome to the 48th edition of Carols by Candlelight, coming to you from the Church of St. Andrew and St. Paul in Montreal. We are so pleased to be able to provide you with this time of beautiful music, favorite carols, and traditional readings as you prepare to celebrate the birth of Christ. While we cannot gather in person in this difficult year, we trust that this will be a time that will bring you joy, peace, beauty, and hope. If you like, you may wish to find some candles to light in your own home as you enjoy this service today. Let us begin with prayer. Prions ensemble. Gracious God, for many of us, Christmas doesn't feel quite normal this year. We are unsure what to think when we cannot enjoy some of the things that we love so dearly. We worry that these changes will bring emptiness instead of fulfillment, loneliness instead of community. We thank you that you came into an imperfect world through imperfect people at an imperfect time. You didn't wait until everything was made right to enter it. You didn't hold yourself back until times were better, more conducive to welcoming you. Rather, you came to set it right, to give hope to our despair, peace to our upheaval, joy to our loneliness, love to our indifference. You came to let us know there is no time when you are not with us, and that your love can penetrate the most fearful and hopeless places of our world and lives. With Mary, our hearts overflow with joy as we wait for the coming of your gift, Jesus Christ. Il est l'étoile qui brille dans la nuit, l'aube qui chasse les ombres, le soleil qui illumine le monde. Gloire à toi, notre Dieu. And now we pray together the prayer that Jesus has taught his followers to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Thank you. The prophet foretells the coming of the Savior. The people that walked in darkness have seen a great light. They that dwell in the land of the shadow of death, upon them hath the light shined. For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government and peace there shall be no end, upon the throne of David, and upon his kingdom, to order it, and to establish it with judgment and with justice from henceforth even forever. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will perform this. Thanks be to God.
Thank you. Deuxième leçon. La naissance de Jésus à Bethléem. Le sixième mois, l'ange Gabriel fut envoyé par Dieu dans une ville de Galilée appelée Nazareth, chez une vierge fiancée à un homme de la famille de David appelé Joseph. Le nom de la vierge était Marie. L'ange entrant chez elle et dit, « Je te salue, toi à qui une grâce a été faite. Le Seigneur est avec toi. Tu es bénie parmi les femmes. » Troublée par cette parole, Marie se demandait ce que pouvait signifier une telle salutation. L'ange lui dit, « N'aie pas peur, Marie, car tu as trouvé grâce auprès de Dieu. Voici que tu seras enceinte. Tu mettras au monde un fils et tu lui donneras le nom de Jésus. Il sera grand et sera appelé Fils du Très-Haut, et le Seigneur Dieu lui donnera le trône de David, son ancêtre. Il régnera sur la famille de Jacob éternellement, son règne n'aura pas de fin. » Marie dit à l'ange, « Comment cela se fera-t-il, puisque je n'ai pas de relation avec un homme? » L'ange lui répondit, « Le Saint-Esprit viendra sur toi, et la puissance du Très-Haut te couvrira de son ombre. » C'est pourquoi le Saint-Enfant qui naîtra sera appelé Fils de Dieu. Voici qu'Élisabeth, ta parente, est elle aussi devenue enceinte d'un fils dans sa vieillesse. Celle que l'on appelait la stérile est dans son sixième mois. En effet, rien n'est impossible à Dieu. Marie dit, « Je suis la servante du Seigneur. Que ta parole s'accomplisse pour moi. » Et l'ange la quitta. Nous rendons grâce à Dieu.
Thank you. Naissance de Jésus à Bethléem. À cette époque-là, parut un édit de l'empereur Auguste qui ordonna le recensement de tout l'Empire. Ce premier recensement eut lieu pendant que Quirinius était gouverneur de Syrie. Tous alla se faire inscrire, chacun dans sa ville d'origine. Joseph aussi monta de la Galilée, de la ville de Nazareth, pour se rendre en Judée dans la ville de David, appelée Bethléem, parce qu'il était de la famille et de la lignée de David. Il y alla pour se faire inscrire avec sa femme Marie, qui était enceinte. Pendant qu'ils étaient là, le moment où Marie devait accoucher arriva, et elle mit au monde son fils premier-né. Elle l'enveloppa de linge et le coucha dans une mangeoire, parce qu'il n'y avait pas de place pour eux dans la salle des hôtes. Nous rendons grâce à Dieu.
Thank you.
Yet done so, I invite you to download the bulletin for tonight's service. There is a link just below the video that you can click on. You will find many more occasions to worship with us, and the details are there. They include the last of our Thursday Advent Chapel services, previewing at 5:30 p.m. on Thursday, with the Reverend Dr. Ross Lockhart as guest preacher and Emmanuel Vukovic as guest violinist. Family worship takes place for the fourth Sunday of Advent next Sunday at 11 a.m. And then on the following day, Monday, December 21st at 7 p.m., is the longest night service, a time of quiet contemplation for those who find this a difficult time of year. On Christmas Eve, our family service will take place as usual at 4 p.m., and then the later service will be shown both at its usual time of 11 and also this year at 7 p.m. for those who wish to worship a little earlier. Then on Christmas Day, we will be broadcasting an informal gathering at 10 o'clock in the morning as we recognize the unusual nature and isolation that this year will bring to many. Traditionally, our offering at this service is dedicated to the music department. If you wish to make a donation, please send it by check or by e-transfer and make a note on the memo line to indicate that it will be given to the music ministry for all the remarkable contributions that they make throughout the year, but especially at Christmas time. And a reminder that CDs of the Quiet are available, including Lux, a collection of Christmas music. The bulletin has details of how you can purchase them.
Thank you. John unfolds the mystery of the Incarnation. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. The same was in the beginning with God. All things were made by him, and without him was not anything made that was made. In him was life, and the life was the light of men. And the light shineth in darkness, and the darkness comprehended it not. There was a man sent from God, whose name was John. The same came for a witness, to bear witness of the light, that all men through him might believe. He was not that light, but was sent to bear witness of that light. That was the true light, which lighteth every man that cometh into the world. He was in the world, and the world was made by him, and the world knew him not. He came unto his own, and his own received him not. But as many as received him, to them gave he power to become the sons of God, even to them that believe on his name, which were born not of blood, nor of the will of the flesh, nor of the will of man, but of God. And the Word was made flesh, and dwelt among us, and we beheld his glory, the glory as of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. And may God bless to us these readings from God's holy word. Amen. Let us pray. Dear God, the promise of the coming of your kingdom has encouraged us through the centuries, and we pray that your church today may continue to look forward with hope and fortitude despite the many obstacles it faces. We ask your blessing upon all who minister in your name, that they will continue to be guided by your word. And we pray particularly for those who face persecution or death because of their faith. And we ask that you give them the strength and hope to carry on, knowing that you travel with them through their trials. As the celebration of your birth draws nearer, we remember that the angels sang of peace to all people of goodwill. So this evening we remember all those who long for peace, those who are caught up in wars and atrocities, certainly not of their making, and for the children and the elderly, the families who are forced to flee their homes. Give them courage and comfort them in their time of trouble. And we pray for those in authority, that they will strive to find solutions to end these conflicts and endeavour to put their grievances aside and work together in harmony. And we pray for your blessing on all those who willingly go to work in these places to bring comfort and aid. God, as we prepare for the feast of Christmas, we know that this year looks very different to other years because of a global pandemic. Yet, we can give thanks for the many blessings you have given us, our friends and families, the opportunities and advantages that we have, and also the knowledge of your love for each of us. Help us then to remember those for whom this season is not a joyous one, those who are lonely, in need, or in despair. Send your healing spirit to those who are ill both in body and mind, and comfort those who mourn. And especially this year, we pray for medical professionals and staff, for essential workers, for parents and school-aged children, for the elderly, and for those with pre-existing health conditions. And we rejoice at the possibility of a vaccine against this dreadful disease. May this become a real hope for all of us. God, we give you thanks for the souls who have departed this life. May they rest in your peace. Your love, O Lord, forever we will sing. From age to age, we will proclaim your faithfulness. As it's in Jesus' name we pray. Now go in peace to love and to serve the Lord. And the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with each and every one of you this evening and indeed forevermore. Amen.